Well, welcome to our humble booth. We have some special guests in our audience tonight. Hopefully we get them all right. If not, it's Pepper's fault, and I'm going to go ahead and land him right now. Hank Sullivan's the president of the Nydia Tea Party. Welcome, Hank. I appreciate you coming out tonight. Thank you so much. Dan Fashawn, election board. Dan, thank you for coming out today. Nydia Tisdale. Nydia, I appreciate you coming out. That's a long ways uphill. Huh? Thank you, honey, for coming out. We sure appreciate it. Miss Linda Umberger, the president of the Republican Party of Dawson County. Chairman of the Dawson County Republican Party. I apologize. I told you that was perfect. I wrote that down. He didn't do it.
Did you let me off the hook?
I did. See, I did it.
Okay,
I told you, any mistakes, I'm going to blame him, but I do most of them. And I do thank each and every one of you for taking the time to come out tonight. And it's a cold night, and I'm sure you have things during the Christmas that you need to be out shopping. But thank you for coming out and showing an interest in this country, because I know each and every one of us love it. And it's good to see the Tea Party active. Okay. I have one announcement I'd like to make, if I could. And this young lady has a pamphlet. And it's a Nydia, it's free, I understand. And she's taking donations. If you'd like to contribute to her cause, they're free. If you don't want to contribute, that's fine too. But if you'd like to, she has a little table in the back with little books on the back. And my understanding is Georgia Sunshine Laws. This is a citizen's guide to open government. There you go. There you go. And, we appreciate her filming. That being said, anyone else has any announcements?
If you had listened to any of the Senate debates, you would have known that every one of them was won by this guy. None of the other Senate candidates even held a candle in front of him. But the press would not let that information out. So unless you were there or you watched it in some way, form or fashion, you wouldn't have known. But Derrick actually shut every one of the other Senate candidates down. And so with that, I just want to turn it over to Derrick Grayson and introduce you to Derrick Grayson.
I want everybody in here to give yourself a hand clap of praise. I'm going to tell you why. You showed up. You care. I want to thank Linda, Vernon, Dale. Linda treated us to a wonderful dinner. Thank you very much. And Dale and Vernon for inviting Team Grayson up here. I'm happy to see Catherine here. She's a true trooper. And all of you, Ms. Tisdale over here to the right, that's a very brave woman. And I want to touch a little bit on that. CBM, corporate backed media, is a tool of both parties, the royals. And I always distinguish that so that folks know I'm not talking about rank and file. And corporate backed media is their greatest tool. I won in the last debate, and I'm going to tell you why I won in the last debate, in the race, in all the debates before that. I was told by the Republican Party that you can't run a statewide race. You have no name recognition. You have absolutely no money. I finished the race, and I won every debate. Don't tell me what I can't do. Now I know how they operate. I also know that the royals of both parties, there is no difference in the two. They are the same. They have the same agenda. They present you with controlled opposition to make you think that they are fighting for you when they are not fighting for you. Folks, stop falling for the okey-doke. You gotta do something different. I was brave enough to get up and go and run to represent you. Be brave enough to send me. Stop re-electing these folk. The people that I'm fighting is not those royals in the Republican Party or the ones that I may be running against. Our biggest adversary is corporate-backed media. The circle of loot is this. You have those at the top that own the corporations. The reason they bought up the corporations is so that the corporations could start buying up the media outlets. Well, why did the corporations start buying ownership of these media outlets? Because we had a president that was taken down by the free press. When I say the free press, unbiased press, that president's name was who?
Richard Nixon.
He was brought down by the free press. That press at that time was allowed to print the truth about the president, and it ended his administration, his candidacy. We no longer have that. So the circle of loot, they now control what you see in corporate-backed media. Well, if we continue to vote for the same kinds of candidates, we will continue to lose people who will not participate in the voting process because they won't see much difference. So you need something that's different. Wherever we went and spoke, I can't tell you the number of people that came up and said, "You got my vote. I didn't know that about Kingston or Gingrich, but I'm voting for you now." That happened everywhere we went, because the singular most important thing that I got people to realize was the reason we're in the condition that we're in is because the people we continue to elect are violating the Constitution. We just need to start voting for people that are going to show a fidelity to the Constitution. I am not bound to party royals. That's point number one. So you ask me, what could we do? We could stop being bound to party royals and start being bound to those that will support the Constitution. That is numero uno. Tell your neighbors, your family, your friends, go to my website, any other resources, read the little booklet that Ms. Tisdale has back there, educate yourself, and donate to the Grayson campaign.
When you say that the royals, I would say, are in bed together, they're the same people.
Yep.
We need to realize that we, Republicans, Independents, Democrats, Libertarians, are not so different, too.
Not anymore today.
Not anymore today. And what it amounts to, in my opinion, is it is them against the rest of us.
Absolutely.
And they're in charge, and until we figure out that I can sit next to a Democrat as a Republican and talk to them about an issue, and they think that we're horrible and we think that they're horrible, it's the whole thing you're saying about the black-white issue with the thing. They have systematically divided this country while they're all the same.
There you go. Sums it right on up. 315 million people allow 536 people to tell them how to live and what to do.
Yep.
The government tells you, "I'm going to create jobs." The government does not create jobs.
That's right.
The American people create the jobs.
There you go.
The people in D.C. are supposed to be serving us. Our police are supposed to protect and serve us. That has changed. But we are the ones responsible. But until you are willing to look in the mirror and own your own complicitness and vow to do something different by not voting for the same people again, the same kinds of people, certainly not re-electing those that have already been in the room, none of this will change. It will only get worse. Ms. Tisdale, I don't know if any of you know her or not. Now, regardless of whether you know her or not, I need to you to step inside the psyche of what's happening with the Royals. At an event where she was videotaping, she was ejected and arrested for videotaping. And Nathan Deal sat in the front row and didn't say a word. See, that is disturbing to me. That a man would, who would not want the public to know what it is that they're doing. How can you say you're mad with Obama about transparency, but get mad because she shows up to record what you are saying? You can't have it both ways. The character that you see in your representatives is what you're going to get in your legislation.
Thank you for your comment, Mr. Grayson. I was wondering, on a personal note, what got you politically active and what was a catalyst for you to run for office? And I respect those who have the courage to run for office.
I got involved in the political process in 2011 because I said just voting is not enough. I started out by campaigning for Ron Paul, and I'll tell you what led me to that. In George Bush's second term, when he brought us TARP, I lost it. I didn't know what else to do. TARP, the biggest corporate welfare program in history. I didn't recognize the Republican Party. Then Obama ran and sold me on change. And I voted for him in his first term. And 18 months after he was in office, he was doing the exact same things that George Bush was doing. That's when I knew both parties, the Royals, were the same. There was no difference in them. And a friend of mine turned me on to Ron Paul. And I started campaigning for Ron Paul. And what made me decide to run, I was at the RNC in Tampa. And to prevent Ron Paul from being nominated from the floor, they changed the rules on the plurality of states from 5 to 8, which prevented him from being nominated on the floor. Now, whether you like Ron Paul or not is really irrelevant. When you deprive the people of their right to choose with disinformation and underhanded shenanigans, you do a disservice to all voters. You should know what is available to you. And with that, I said, I can no longer abide the corruption of either party. Now, I will die a Republican. I am not leaving the Republican Party, and I'm not trying to destroy the Republican Party. But I'll be damned and go to hell before I continue to sit back and let the Royals destroy the Republican Party that was responsible for the emancipation of the slaves and the 14th Amendment. I won't do it. I will fight you if you're in this room.
Thank you.